I am Mr. D.K. Ojha from DAV Public School. At the present, I am going to teach you the topic of a grammar. Name of the topic is bias. First of all, we have to know about the definition of bias. It means, what is bias? In the traditional grammar, bias is the quality of a verb that indicates whether its subject acts or is acted upon. The distinction between the active and passive bias applies only to transitive verbs. After that, I am going to say about the types of the bias. There are two types of bias. First is active bias and second is passive bias. Active bias is completely depend on the subject and passive bias is depend upon the object. When the sentence is written mainly as starting with the subject, verb and object, that is known as active bias. And passive bias, object becomes subject and after that, according to the subject, verb is given and always the third part of the verb is written as. As example for Ram writes a letter. This is the form of active bias. Just alike, a letter is written by Ram. A letter is written by Ram. Is the form of passive bias. Some important facts of the passive bias is subject becomes object and object becomes subject. When subject becomes object, that is known as agent. That is known as agent. And according to the structure, mainly sentences are divided as usually the tense. Present indefinite tense, present continuous, present perfect. After that past indefinite, past continuous and past perfect. Same as future indefinite, future continuous or future perfect. We have to classify it as the structure. Suppose that any sentence is written as present indefinite tense. The structure will be subject plus V1 oblique V5 plus object. And in passive voice, subjective object plus ERM plus V3 plus by plus agent. As for the example, Ram writes a letter. A letter is written by Ram. Just in the continuous, it means present continuous. The structure of present continuous is subject plus is RM plus V4 plus object. That is the form of active voice. And in the form of the passive voice, subjective object plus ERM plus being plus V3 plus by plus agent. As for the example, Ram is writing a letter, that is in the active voice, and a letter is being written by Ram. A letter is being written by Ram. That is the form of the passive voice. Just like this, in present perfect tense, the structure of active voice is subject plus has oblique have plus V3 plus object. And in passive voice, objective subject plus has oblique have plus been plus V3 plus by plus agent. As the example, Ram has written a letter. In the passive voice, a letter has been written by Ram. That's it. that sentence in the present tense. After that, I am going to start the past tense. First of all, past indefinite tense. The structure of past indefinite tense is subject plus V2 plus object. It is the form of the active voice, and in the passive voice, subjective object plus was were plus V3 plus by plus agent. As for the example, I wrote a letter. I wrote a letter. In the passive form, a letter was written by me. A letter was written by me. And in the past tense, it means past continuous tense, just is written as present indefinite. The structure of past and continuous is subject plus was were plus V4 plus object. That is changed as subjective object plus was were plus being plus V3 plus by plus agent. As the example, I am writing a letter. I am writing a letter. A letter, I was writing a letter. As a, when it will be changed at the passive voice, a letter was being written by me. A letter was being written by me. And in the structure of the past perfect, in active, subject plus had plus V3 plus object. And when it will be changed as the passive voice, subjective object plus had plus been plus V3 plus by plus agent. As for the example, I had eaten a mango. In passive, a mango had been eaten by me. A mango had been eaten by me. Just I am going to start in the future tense. First of all, future indefinite. The structure of future indefinite is subject plus shall will plus given plus, and when it will be changed in the passive form, subjective object plus shall will plus be plus V3 plus by plus agent. As for the example, I will write a letter. I will write a letter. Sorry, I am going to repeat again the future indefinite. The structure of future indefinite is subject plus shall will plus V1 plus object. Then it will be changed into passive voice. Then the structure will be subjective object plus shall will plus be plus V3 plus by plus agent. As for the example, I will write a letter. Then it will be written as passive voice. A letter will be written by me. And generally, future continuous will not be changed as the passive voice. But we will make it. The structure of the future continuous is subject plus shall will plus be plus V4 plus object. Then we will change it as the passive, subjective object plus shall oblique will plus be plus being plus V3 plus by plus agent. As for the example, he will be writing a letter. Then it will become as in the passive voice, a letter will be being written by me. And in the future perfect tense, the structure of future perfect tense is subject plus shall have oblique will have plus V3 plus object. And its passive form is subjective object plus shall have plus will have plus been plus V3 plus by plus agent. As for the example, I will have eaten a mango. And in the passive, a mango will have been eaten by me. That's all. And after that, I will teach tomorrow for the out of the tense of passive voice. Thank you. Thank you very much.